This is an aluminum handle. One of my customers, Ray Fisher from the Hammerblow Mining Museum out of Tucson, Arizona, had sent me. And we're going to prep this now and get it ready to mold. He also sent me a really nice sign from an old Leroy compressor. Haven't quite decided where I'm going to put it yet. But here, as I said, I'm prepping the pattern prior to ramming, and it took me about 4 or 5 days. Working on it a little bit here and a little bit there, adding filler, sanding, letting that dry. Okay, this is it. This side along with this side was flat and even concaved a little bit, if I remember right. So there was absolutely no way this was going to pull clean out of the sand. The hole is still going to give me fits. This side is flat. This side has letters on it, so I'm going to put that up first. I'm going to hold my finger down on it, pack sand up under it. This is the false drag. This is just going to be used temporarily to establish the parting line. Here I'm putting parting dust on it to keep the debris I'm carving out here from sticking to the face. This is temporary. It'll only be used just to establish the orientation of the casting, keep it level. And from there, we'll finish our cope and then remake the drag. Here I'm trying to go ahead and get a level plane fixed for the riser. Because I'm coping down, I have a slope going all the way around. I'm going to have at least one flat spot just for the riser. Now I'm wrapping the pattern at this stage. I want this to be loose and fall out of this mold when I get ready to ram the upper half. Normally, I would never pull a pattern from the sand like that, but it's not going to really matter on this part of it since it is a false drag. All I want to do is make sure I have good clean parting lines all the way around that are clean. And once I established that, I was able to just drop this back in here, because basically all this is for is just to hold it in place. Keep it level, keep it on center line. Parting lines don't always come out as clean as I'd like. Here I'm feathering over the edges just to break any fragile sand that could wash into the mold. All right, so that completes the drag. Now we're going to finish it out with a coat. Notice how close I keep the riser to the thick part of this casting. The lip on my crucible has eroded away, so it makes pouring in small pouring basins kind of difficult. Now on this mold, it appears that I poured short, but I'll have you know that it actually turned out to be a full casting after all. So I didn't have any scrap castings on this batch. Well, this is it. And the riser did its job. No puckering right there. I usually don't include all the steps with the grind and cleanup on castings, but I decided I'd go ahead and fit that into this video. I need to invest in a good belt sander. Right now, that's not a priority. I'm able to keep up pretty well with the right angle grinder. And, you know, when you're using a cutoff wheel, you can remove a lot of excessive material with that and then come back over it with a finer grinding wheel just to dress everything up. On this particular casting, I went from a cutoff wheel straight to a flap wheel just to slick everything over. I'm not sure how much time I had involved in the grind and cleanup on this, but it was under 30 minutes. Okay, this is it. I'm gonna let the customer drill the hole out. I don't do machining here. The lettering turned out. That's where the vent wires were. Wish that had come out a little better there, but I'm not gonna complain. I think it looks better than the original one did anyway. Finally got this one ready to go. All he's gonna have to do is wire wheel the paint off of this. He could do that, or he could throw it in the oven and crank it up to about 400 degrees. And after the house gets stunk up good, all this stuff will be cooked off along with the water putty. That should soften up and just pop right off of there. So he'll still be able to use this one. I wanted to give y'all an idea of what's in my plumbing for this year and next. Right now, this is top priority for those of you that have been asking Keith about the 12-inch straight edges. I'm doing everything I can to get the production patterns made where we can hurry up and get an inventory of the cast iron ones. I sent Keith one in iron straight off of the master pattern about a month ago, and he was able to machine it, and he said that turned out great, so let's go ahead and get production patterns made, and then from there he'll machine those, see how they're going to look. Once he gives me the approval, I'm going to go ahead and stock up an inventory. We'll get it at least 100 cast, and once I have 100, he'll announce it. But for those of you wondering where we're at on that, that's where we're at. Also in the plumbing, I know a lot of you, if not all of you, watch Mr. Pete Tubal Cane. I'm going to let him tell you more about this when we get closer to the time to take action on that. Same thing with Barzy Industrial. I'm having some issues getting these patterns to come out. They keep tearing loose the logo along with A-Bomb 79's logo. It's tearing out. So I'm not going to tell you too much about this stuff because I'm nowhere near at that point with that, but it'll be brought up later. Right now, our main focus is getting the straight edges rolling. I also have Andrew Alexander's patterns here. He's waiting on. I've got to get cast. They will probably be coming up in upcoming videos. One in particular that I'm anxious to do is a very old pattern to a blacksmith fire pot. And that's the bottom side. I'm not sure how old it is. I have no idea who the manufacturer was, but it's pretty neat. As I said, I also have several more patterns Andrew sent me. And for those of you who are not familiar with Andrew, he is Blacksmith Tools on Instagram. And he's in Dallas, Texas. He has the world's largest collection of blacksmith stuff, to my knowledge. Pretty neat setup. But anyway, funny thing about the fire pot is I'm wanting to have a forge built out here. And Josie's going to build it for me. And may as well cast me one off of these as well. Back to what the video was all about. We got this done and get it out of here. One of my next projects down the road will be to make Dollar a bigger bowl. I made this one several years ago, and I had no idea she'd be eating feet out of it one day. But anyway, I'll do a video on that when we get ready to tackle that. Hope everyone enjoyed the video. Like and subscribe if you haven't already to see all upcoming projects happening here at Windy Hill Foundry. Until then, I hope you have a good day.